Welcome everyone to deck profile number 13. We're doing my Twilight Lightsworn deck, and I'm very happy that someone requested this one because I kind of wanted to do it for a while. But seeing as I have a lot of projects that I'm working on, I don't really do a lot of deck profiles out of myself. I wait for people to request them, and literally 15 minutes ago, I was requested by ValanTinE1234 to do my Twilight Lightsworn deck. So here I am doing that exact thing. Now, I've used this deck in 3 duels. I believe 6, 13, and 39, if I recall correctly. So it's been a while since I've last used them. And the reason I haven't used them for a while is for 2 reasons. 1, because I just have so many decks and I want to try so many new things. And 2, because I feel it's not as good anymore against the new decks like Evilstorm, Dragon Rules, Prophecy. It needs a definite update. It definitely needs an update since what it has been. When I wasn't playing competitively, like in World Championship 2007, well, no, World Championship 2008, and then the 2 years that came after that, I was, well, 3 actually, I was just playing Gravekeepers as my main deck in the games, and then I started off with that on DN as well, but shortly after I played Lightsworns, and I played Lightsworns as my main deck for a while, and ever since I didn't use it as my main anymore, I haven't really had a main. Really, so, but yeah, here's the deck. There have been a few minor changes since the videos, I believe. So this is the deck that I used in Duel 39 with a few minor changes. As I said, it needs some updates to compete with the current meta game, and there's a good amount of new cards that could be used in it. I just haven't taken the time to update it yet. I kind of want to. So, yeah. Let's just get into the deck profile before my rambling goes on for too long. BLS. Because Twilight Lightsworn, Light and Dark, why not play BLS? Car Trooper. I only have 1 copy in it. I technically could use 2, because with Lightsworn and also with Twilight, you want to get stuff in the grave, so you could run a second. Might as well run a second. I don't really know why I only have 1. And seeing as the side deck right now is mostly cards that I'm just thinking about, but not really using, I guess I'll just put Card Trooper over here as a card I'm thinking about, since the side deck isn't too serious. Celestia Lightsworn Angel. You don't get the chance to tribute someone that often, but Celestia does help with her effect and destroying stuff. Chaos Sorcerer. Originally, I did have more of Chaos Sorcerer in the deck, but yeah, it became limited. So, 1 Chaos Sorcerer, 1 Effect Veiler, 1 Eren. Now, seeing as I do want to get Judgment Dragon out, and this is not a pure Lightsworn deck, I took multiple copies of the Lightsworns I felt were most useful, and then 1 copy of a couple others, just to have multiple a lot of names of Lightsworns in the decks to make Judgment Dragon plays easier. I have Gorse, because it's dark and it's good. Honest, because I run quite a lot of lights, so why not run Honest? Jayne, originally I remember having Garroth in its place, but Garroth only really had 50 more attack, which defending-wise only cost me 50 life points when switching to Jayne, but attacking-wise, Jayne gains 300 attack when attacking another monster. That definitely has helped me get over a couple monsters. And Jayne always mills in the end phase, and Garroth doesn't. So that's why I switched it. I have Genus Electron Mender. I do believe this was one of the cards that wasn't in my deck at the time I used them in duel videos. I had Arcus in the deck. I found that I barely ever used Arcus. The only thing I really used Arcus for was using it as Xyz with Lumina. But I barely even used the rank 3s anymore. I just used Lumina to summon something rank 4, and then, well, to summon a level 4, and then go from there. So, because the effect of Arcus, I just wasn't using it, and the only time it really did have an effect, it was stopping my own monster reborn. So, no. I decided to switch to Genus as a wall, because not a lot of the other names of Lightsworns were really that good, I felt, but I didn't want another name, so one that I hadn't used yet, so I decided to go with Genius for a wall, and who knows, the effect might come in handy. 3 Judgment Dragons, because I do want it. 2 Lumina, I started with Lumina when it was semi-limited. It's now, or when it was even limited, I don't even remember. But yeah, it's now unlimited. I decided to keep it at 2 because I feel that's how it works best in this deck. 2 Lila to just because it has good 1700 attack and it can destroy spells and traps. 2 Necro Gardener to negate attacks. I technically could also go with Bacon Saver because it has higher attack. And I do believe Bacon Saver is also dark. Yeah. And it has 100 higher attack. And the defense of Necro Gardener, you don't really use it often. But the reason I'm going with Necro Gardener and not Bacon Saver is because Necro Gardener is level 3, which allows it for Xyz plays with like cards like Lumina. And Bacon Saver is level 2, so that doesn't work. I have the Tour Guide Engineer here with Tour Bus and Night Assailant. Originally, it was 3 Tour Guides and Sangan, like most people had. But then I switched to Night Assailant as when the first when Tour Guide was semi-limited, and then Tour Bus, because I felt that was the only really good other one that I could go for. And with it, I could technically just shuffle a monster back into the deck that I kind of want back into the deck. Now, Plaguesplitter Zombie as a tuner for some synchro plays. I barely ever use Effect Failure for the synchro, so really Plaguesplitter Zombie is the only one I use, and it can be used from the graveyard, which works with a Twilight thing. But ever since Brenak, Dragon of the Ice Barrier, got banned, I haven't really used Plaguesplitter's effect that much, and I haven't done as many synchro plays, because Brenak was my go-to guy with Plaguesplitter Zombie. So there's a good chance that when I remake this deck and update it, I'll just take up Plaguesplitter, because I just don't do as many synchro plays anymore. 2 Rico Lightsworn Hunter, because it can destroy and mill 3 cards. This guy is just really good. It just is. 2 Wolf, because you mill quite a lot of cards, and then Wolf can just summon itself, getting a free monster. It's very nice. Now, I do realize that it can be a dead draw, because if you once you draw it, you can't really do much with it. But that's what I have Solar Recharge and Monster Reincarnation for. Not only because it just helps speed up the deck, but also it makes your dead draws, being Wolf, Lightsworn, Beast, and in some cases, Judgment Dragon or Celestia, you can actually use them to get something else that you want. 1 Allure of Darkness, because it's draw power, and I have a good amount of darks. Charge of the Light Brigade, mill cards, add whatever Lightsworn I want. Heavy to take care of back row, because I don't really use a lot of traps myself. Monster Reborn to bring some monster back. Monster Reincarnation, originally when I played this deck, I believe in like Duel 6 and 13 at least, I don't remember if it was the case in 39 anymore, I played 3 Reincarnation. I decided to switch it to 2 to allow for Treacherous Trapple to enter. Reincarnation isn't very used very often, but it does help with the consistency of Lightsworn. Because Lightsworn, like, it's Yu-Gi-Oh's a card game, it's always somewhat based on luck with the cards that you draw. But with Lightsworn, that's even more the case because of the cards you mill. Like, cards I want to mill are different names of Lightsworns. I want to mill, let's say, Eren, a Lila, a Genus, and then I'll have Rico destroyed by battle or something, and then I'll have 4 for Judgment Dragon. But I can also mill MSD, Judgment Dragon, BLS. Yeah, there go 2 of my strongest monsters. So what do I do with Monster Reincarnation? With Monster Reincarnation, you can bring that card that you milled back to your hand. Technically, card advantage-wise, it's a -1, but to be able to get back a boss monster or any card that you really want, possibly even Honest, a card that you want to get it back to your hand, that really helps. So Monster Reincarnation definitely helps with the consistency of this deck. And, like, I believe I've done in one of the duel videos, although might not have been in a video, just in a duel afterwards, where I had 3 Lightsworns in the grave and a Judgment Dragon. I used Monster Reincarnation to send Wolf there, making it 4 Lightsworns, get the Judgment Dragon back from my graveyard, and summon it to the field and, well, nuke the field with its effect. And that actually was the inspiration for one of the moves in Yu-Gi-Oh! Burst Chapter 2, so go read that. This deck was definitely the inspiration. 2 MSD to take care of back row, Solar Recharge because it helps very much with Lightsworns, and if you dead draw into Wolf, it's not really a dead draw if you have Solar Recharge. And then, seeing as I don't really play a lot of traps, Treacherous Trapple to destroy 2 monsters on the field. That can be very helpful. The extra deck, and once again, this is the old extra deck, it can definitely use some updates. Like, Star Leaves, Pala Dynamo would probably be a good one to add. And seeing as I don't synchro that often anymore, I'll probably take out a couple of the synchros and we'll replace them with new Xyz monsters, because there's a lot of new ones. Catastrophe I'll probably keep in. Android, I had it in there to be a little stronger than Catastrophe if, like, the opponent also had Darks. But I'll probably take that one out. Orion Dragon, this was more in the Synchro Saga, like just before the Xyz monsters came out. It's barely ever useful these days. Like, the opponents sometimes synchro, like Six Samurai still synchros, Constellers. Well, Constellers do Xyz, never mind. I was thinking of something else that was confusing them. But anyway, Orion Dragon's really only helped me once. Was a great match winner then, but gonna take that one out. Gaia Knight was my replacement for Brionac, but yeah, it's the strongest rank 6, level 6 synchro we have at the moment. Possibly, like, there's the new card, Vulcan. New level 6 synchro that's coming out. I really don't know its effect very well. Might actually be useful. I'll look into it. Black Rose, I'll probably keep that one, because it's... that's not used very often. It's just like a card just in case you're in an emergency and need to use the nuke effect to clear the entire field, which is mostly the opponent's field. That's what most people use Black Rose for. Scrap Archfiend deserves a stronger version if I can go for a rank 7, level 7. Probably I'll take that out. And then I have Stardust and Scrap, which I'll probably both keep in. At least Stardust, possibly Scrap as well. And I have Leviathan as a rank 3 Xyz that I could go for. With Arcus making place for Genus, I'm gonna take out some rank 3s. I still have the Tour Guide engine, so as long as I'm going to keep in the Tour Guide engine, I'm going to keep my rank 3s. I have Leviathan Dragon and Zen Mains. Two Zen Mains, because I just use it quite a lot. Might cut Zen Mains down to one later to make space for more others. Acid Golem as a sort of a last push if I really need the attack power. Levavel Chain to add, like, BLS to the top of my deck, or Judgment Dragon, or send that fourth Lightsworn to the graveyard. It can be used for various purposes. I'll probably keep that one in for the reasons I just explained. Pappy Operative, I use this quite a lot. It's not as useful anymore, I feel, as it used to be, but it can be useful in some occasions, but I'll probably replace it with other cards. And then just the rank 4, like 2500 attack, that's high attack, and it can negate attack, so why not run Utopia was the question at the time. Now, for my side deck, I had a couple of cards that were pretty good side deck cards that could work with my deck, and some other cards that I just thought about. DD Crow, because, you know, Chaos Dragons were a thing at one point, remember? Thunder King, to stop Xyz plays and stuff. Dark Hole, to destroy stuff. I don't have it in my main deck, I have it in my side deck, because, against some decks it works, and I'll probably put it in my main deck, when I update this deck. MSD, two Chaos Hunters. I never actually got to use it in a match because I hadn't used the deck in a while, but Chaos Hunter was a good choice, I felt, for the time, like against Chaos Dragons, for example. Here's a second card trooper that I just put in. Beckoning Light. I've seen some Lightsworn players play this. I've actually only tested it with it once, and then I just wasn't lucky with when I drew it. But you can discard your entire hand and then get light monsters back, which can be good, can be bad, depending on the situation. Blasting the Ruins. You need 30 cards in your graveyard for that. Like, Lightsworn's mill fast, but usually that does make for a faster game. So usually the game is over before I hit 30 in the graveyard, and 30 is a lot. Shadow Imprisoning Mirror to stop dark monsters. Injectors as well. Injectors were a thing back then, and then, like, yeah, Chaos Dragons, I guess. But it did stop, like, the effects of Chaos Sorcerer. I couldn't use Gores. I couldn't use Gardner. Couldn't use Tour Guide. Well, technically, I could still use Gores, summon it from my hand, but I just couldn't summon the token. Monster Reincarnation, as I said, I replace it with Treacherous. I have Glorious Illusion, which lets you summon a Lightsworn from the graveyard and helps you mill some stuff. And then Imperial Iron Will, I don't remember why I put it in. Probably as a stop to Chaos Dragons, and right now It's to stop the dragon rulers. So, yeah, good stuff. Yeah, this was the deck profile for my Lightsworn, my Twilight Lightsworn deck, ValanTinE1234. I hope you are happy with this deck. I'm definitely going to update it and then use it in a duel at some point, and I'll just probably give you a deck profile then as well. Alright guys, I'm going to see you later. I'm going to continue working on Yu-Gi-Oh! Burst and the next deck request duel, because that is pretty much ready to go. And I'll talk to you later. Bye.